Today we're going to do a technical tour of a really unique vessel. It's 68.7 meters, 225 feet, with a 37-foot beam. That's 11.2 meters. This vessel was originally built as a high-speed, ice-class search and rescue vessel for a Scandinavian government. And to visit this vessel, I came to Vigo, Spain, which is up in the northwest corner of Spain, where it so happens I have been before.
In 1972, 50 years ago, I sailed on my father's Palmer Johnson 48 from Bermuda here, Bayonne, Spain, which is a beautiful port just next to Vigo, Spain. There's an amazing Parador castle overlooking the harbor here where all the yachts tied up after the race.
So let's head back to Vigo and go aboard this search and rescue vessel that I think will convert into an amazing expedition yacht. There are a number of features on this vessel that make it unique. It is 19 or 20 knot speed. It's ice class. It has a bulbous bow, which you don't see on ice class. And it has retractable stabilizers, which you have to have on ice class. This vessel is diesel electric with Rolls-Royce motors and 3 Mon generators. Today we're going to have a tour of the vessel with Sokas Kardama, whose family has owned and operated this shipyard for over 100 years. We're starting the tour up on the bridge, which is vast. It has 360-degree views through big glass, and all of the systems that you see here are redundant. There's a backup for every system on the vessel. It has 4 different stations from which you can operate the vessel. It's got 2 wing stations, and then on the aft side, it also has a full operational station. So looking at the plans here, what you always want to do on a conversion is make use of the existing structure as much as possible. So the bridge deck is perfect, but what we want to do is extend the aft side of the bridge deck here and make a sky lounge. The crane is going to swivel out of the way, so you can make a sky lounge all the way back to here. And now you've got a sun deck that is quite vast, that will go all the way from the beginning of the bridge this far aft. And you've got tremendous guest space here that is just ready to pop.
All of the decks have heavy thermal and acoustic insulation. You immediately get the feeling that everything is oversized. The ceilings are high, the windows are large, and it feels like they didn't quite know what to do with all the extra space they had. This is great news when it comes to converting this to an expedition yacht, because we have use for this space.
So we have to remind ourselves this vessel is 225 feet long and it can operate with only 9 crew. And the accommodations that it does have for crew are oversized. The cabins are twice the size of what they should be for crew cabins. And this presents the opportunity in the conversion that we can convert space and accommodate all our guests and the owners and still have plenty of room for the crew. So right below the bridge, you have the galley and the mess. The captain, chief engineer, directly under them are the crew cabins. So that's about 75 feet of accommodations in there on 2 decks. This gives us a lot of leeway to repurpose this existing interior space, and we don't have to add any more accommodation areas in the hull. You've got a large office here. You've got the captain, the chief engineer, another office over here, another utility space here. So this can all be an owner's suite on the foredeck with access onto the foredeck. You've certainly got room here for large walk-in closets, his and her heads, and even another little cabin for staff or for children connected to the owner's suite. Going down a deck, you've got a hospital, you've got a big engineer's cabin, an officer's cabin, a locker room. So the crew quarters can be consolidated, let's say up here, and you could have large guest suites back here or vice versa. You've also got a void space up here. You've got a space here that's probably 30 feet by 25 feet. So let's go back on board and have a look at these spaces. Here's an example of a large underutilized space on the main deck. It's currently configured as a gym.
but it could be put to a better use. There are two very large stairwells connecting the decks.
As already noted, each of these crew cabins are large enough to become guest suites, and the hallways offer more width than you would normally see on a luxury yacht.
The galley is modern and state-of-the-art, with lots of light, great ventilation, and plenty of room for multiple crew members to work here at the same time. Four walk-ins for cold storage and for a freezer that allow the vessel to have an endurance of several weeks. Now let's get into the vessel systems. This is the engineer's main control station. It's on the main deck, not below deck. And as the vessel is electric, you will see multiple breakers and panels to distribute and control the electric currents.
The electric power plants generate 4.25 megawatts of power, and they go to two 1800 kilowatt engines, which deliver 4900 horsepower to the propellers. It has active front end drivers, blackout prevention system, and generator protection modules. All of this is redundant, so any of the power systems that go down have full backup. It features an engine room workshop for repairs at seas, which is better equipped than anything I've ever seen before.
Vessel has ice class rotary vane steering gear. The piping is all insulated, the cable runs, and the hydraulic lines are all extremely well organized and open and accessible.
Engine room is two decks high. It's completely insulated. There's lots of space between the equipment for access and maintenance. All of the engines and systems are connected with an integrated alarm monitoring control system that has over 1,000 channels. This system provides improved marine vessel supervision for safety and management. The microprocessor reads and records engine output data and monitors all of the critical ship functions such as engines, pumps, and valves. This system complies with full marine classification by Lloyd's, DNV, and other class societies.
Here we are looking down into the deepest part of the ice-strengthened hull, which has stainless steel lining, and it is spotless.
There are some other unique features that I want to point out here for this search and rescue vessel. This looks like a helicopter platform, but it is actually an evacuation point for a helicopter to pick up an injured rescued person. So it's a winch-only platform, and they winch the injured person up to the helicopter. However, it's situated where you would want to put a helipad, and so it can be rebuilt and reinforced as a helipad there on the stern. Now, the other unique thing that this vessel has, we can see it better down here. This is a emergency rescue tender bay here, which can be used for a yacht tender. And the unique thing about this kind of a ramp situation is that the tender can be launched while the vessel is underway. And that was important for search and rescue, but it's also useful on a yacht because you don't have to stop the yacht, anchor, get all stabilized, and then have the crew mess around with a crane. So you can launch your tender right away out of this tender garage or tender bay in the transom. And that is a unique feature, and I think that that's something that adds value to this hull as well. So that's a quick overview of this 68-meter search and rescue vessel. It's only got 450 hours on the engines. It's like new. It's in Vigo, Spain at the Cardama shipyard, and Cardama can convert this into a global expedition yacht in probably 12 to 16 months because all the systems are there and ready to go, and really all that needs to be done is a reconfiguration of the accommodations and also the tender toys and helideck. So this is a unique opportunity for the right person that wants a 20 knot ice class stabilized diesel electric vessel that is just about ready to go. I mean, it's a real opportunity as far as I can tell from all the boats that I've seen in Europe and in the United States. So if you're interested in this boat, give me a call.